Science and Significance of Ugadi. After a very short commercial break, we would warmly welcome each one of you again to this very special episode on Ugadi and the scientific relevance behind it. You mentioned that this time the Ugadi is actually prosperity only because the rising is in the Virgo. So, and also you also mentioned that there is a lot of laziness, lethargy for one and all. So how to negate this and what happens when such things happen?
Okay, while the overall phenomena is actually circumstances are going to be positive, by and large all the living beings will probably be affected by tamas. So the best way to negate tamas is through tamas is basically a chemical reaction. So the best way is to negate it through chemicals, and food is also a part of is a chemical that you consume. So what you basically have to do is you have to first of all minimize on the tamas foods. So tamas foods could basically be alcohol, could be meat, it could be chicken, pork, fish, goat, etc. And it could also, also foods like which are cool or frozen, they also, add to tamas. So for those ice cream lovers, try to minimize the amount of ice cream that you take. You know, you can't resist it, but try to minimize it. Avoid cool drinks, especially carbonated drinks. Now, while you minimize the tamas, you also have to increase the intake of the sattva and rajas, which is very important. Both have to be increased in equal proportions. So when we talk about sattva, we basically talk about all these nuts like almonds, cashews, walnut and berries. So all these things are part of the sattva foods.
And also, what about the each one of the zodiac constellations? What changes happen? Because just before the interview, we just discussed that I had a misconception. There is a different alignment for each zodiac. You just made me understand that no, the constellations are as usual, they are fixed. So what happens, what changes happens in a being then?
So depending on every Rashi, when I say Rashi, the sign occupied by the moon after deducting Ayanamsha. So when we basically have to look at each person's Rashi, and then we can broadly figure out what he or she would actually be going through in this year. So if for those audience who don't know what their Rashi is, the best is to go to a nearby astrologer, give your date, place and time of birth, and they'll be able to quickly calculate this and give it to you. So what I'll do is I'll list out all the 12 Rashis, and one by one I'll start going through this, right? Let's begin with Mesha or Ace Aries. Overall, this year is going to be a bad period for them. While there are four planets that are good, certain planets actually are not going to be very favorable. For example, professionally, their work will actually end up in failure. So they have to be a little cautious about these things. They will constantly encounter disputes with their bosses. And there will always be scenarios where, they'll not be able to meet deadlines. So those people who are salaried have to be a little cautious during this year, but because the tendencies actually influence these things. And those who are not salaried, that is the business professionals, right, there will be unnecessary expenses that they will actually encounter. So there will be a lot of leakage of finances. Also, in domestic happiness, between the husband and wife, there'll be a lot of disputes that happen very regularly. There'll be a lot of quarreling, misunderstanding that happens. And it should not be with any stones. It should just be a plain one. No gemstone, no precious. Just a simple, straightforward silver ring or a pendant or a bracelet, anything would work. So this would be for Mesha Rashi.
So you just said that there's a lot of mishappenings which may occur. So to negate all that, you have also given the remedial measure. Correct. Next comes the Taurus or the Vrishabha Rashi.
That's correct. So next is Vrishabha Rashi. So professionals, this is a mediocre state. So professional will face some difficulties and may not get success easily. They might get some problems when, especially when it comes to promotions. A lot of co-workers actually can cause a lot of problems. Those who are in business, they might actually end up in legal complications.
Okay.
Now your finances will be okay. It will neither be too high nor low. From a marital perspective, it'll be like a mixed bag. So it'll neither be good nor be bad, but it'll be very volatile. Sometimes good, sometimes bad. So it is not like an average, but it'll continuously keep being volatile.
Shifting,
so that's what
volatile.
We call it as mixed bag.
Okay.
When we look at it from a student's perspective, I think they tend to get deviated from their studies, and again they tend to become lazy. So it's very important that they continue to have concentration. while four planets are good, I think the Saturn in the eighth house from their Rashi needs to be taken care of. Uh-huh. So the remedial measure that I would suggest is, one is, you know, it's actually very good if they plant as many trees as possible. So planting of saplings is the best remedial measure there. Mm-hmm. Second one is to actually go in for a vegetarian diet, because that will actually take care of their constitution, and they'll be able to, you know, handle the entire year much more better. So average, it's a mediocre year, so they have to be cautious of how things.
So a mixed bag is what you suggested.
That's correct.
So and so being close to a nature little bit will help them overall constitutional way, and also the way to deal with the pressures.
Being close to nature, and all most importantly contributing to, you know, the vegetation. So contributing to nature as well.
Okay. So we'll just go to the next Gemini, but after a very short commercial break.
Sure.
Viewers, here we are slipping into a very short commercial break again, after which we'll try to know more about the other zodiacal constellations.